Hey guys, Justin with Ready Business Systems. In my last video, I showed you how I created this AI chatbot using a custom version of ChatGPT to handle our customer service on our website. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I integrated an AI agent. We're using a service called Rosie to answer our phone calls and for our phone system and save some money and automate that there. So we use RingCentral for our phones, and we have what we call our menu here. So when people call in, they're going to be greeted with a prompt, which I used to pay for a custom recording on Fiverr, but I just decided to use an AI recording to generate our greeting for our answering for our company. So I'll play that here, just to give you an idea what that sounds like. I'm going to stop there because it's all that's relevant to this video. So the first point I want to make is this is an AI voice. It was free, sounds very realistic, and just super cool. You can generate that professional recording when you pick up the phone. The second thing I want to point out is what we did is we set up our extensions here. So key presses. So as that prompt says, press one for new quotes, press two for questions if you're an existing client. So the way these are routed is when you press one, it's going to our Rosie AI answering service. So this is this goes to the AI. It can actually talk. I'll show you an example of that in a second. It's gonna take in our new leads and send us an email. Eventually, I am gonna get this integrated into our form so it can actually ask people's names and plug them right into our contact form and get them right into our CRM. Press two goes to customer service. So essentially all the new leads we're channeling through this AI, it's very expensive. I think it's like $50 a month we're paying right now. But number two for existing accounts, this goes to both our office, which we have, our office is located in the Philippines. We have Filipinos answering the phone, and they can do a lot more than the AI can at this moment. So it's going to go to them. If they don't pick up, it goes to our answering service, which is local. It's located out of Florida. They're going to pick up the phone. They can update our credit cards in our system. They can also take in new leads. So we're trying to cut down this cost. What we're doing essentially is using the Rosie AI to replace our answering service and our Filipinos answering the phone to cut down on costs there, because obviously the AI is going to be cheaper than any real person. So we're trying to cut down on costs there. So we have this set up for the extensions. Like I said, extension one is going to go as Rosie AI. So you can see here we have once they call, it's going to have the AI recording that prompts them what they want. If they press one, it's going to bring them straight to the Rosie answering service. And I'll show you how that works in here. So you can see here under calls, this is one of our recordings, and I'll play it out just so you can see how this Rosie AI, it's like, works surprisingly well and sounds very realistic, and you probably wouldn't even know it's an AI answering person. So let me play this recording for you so you can see exactly how this works out. So anyway, you guys get the idea there. One thing you could hear, Steve, this is a test call. You can hear Steve in the background. It wasn't pronouncing our company name right. So what we did already fix this, but we had to put like an R and a space. So it says Rylons. That's not the name of it. And you wouldn't really know, honestly. A person probably wouldn't know either. So what we did is we put R space I space Lons, and now it answers correctly. But this stuff is super cool right now. The information is just getting sent through an email. I'll show you what this looks like. So here's the actual email we got in. It says, Steve Martino called, it gives a little summary here, called to request a quote. Team will get back to them. It's going to forward over this information. What my next step is, I'm going to get this to put, I'm going to get Rosie, I think it's a little upgraded plan, I'm going to get it to implement, to actually enter the information to our contact form, because right now that's going to be a manual process. This is going to go to our Filipino assistants. They're going to take this information and plug it to our lead form. I want to get rid of that manual step and have the AI put it directly into our lead form. So it's working pretty well. I'm pretty happy with it. And I think it's awesome. I think this is going to really save us money, first of all, because, you know, anything that's AI is going to cost less than a human. You know, our Philippine assistants cost less than a local person, but AI costs even less than that. And our answering service isn't that cheap because it is, you know, it's located in Florida and it's a third party company. They pick up all the time. So, you know, our Philippines can't pick all the time. So we have, you know, the answering service as a backup. But this, you know, Rosie's going to pick up all the time right away, bring in our new leads, and it's going to cost far less than using any sort of real human. So yeah, super cool stuff. Have any questions, feel free to comment below. And if you're interested in having this set up in your business, feel free to reach out to us. It's readybusinesssystems.com. Thanks for watching, guys.